So we ready ourselves then for the first medal deciding final of the day, the A final in the men's C2 1000 meters. And there is the lineup. Lane one in Romania, Liviu Dumitrescu and Victor Mihalacci, rising stars of the NC2 1000 meters.
C2 1000
meters.
And a tricky one to call as we go through the starters, but this pair certainly one of the favourites, Kretschmer and Kuschela. Quickest time in qualifying. No, the reason why Germany's world champion Stefan Holtz and Tomasz Wilenczek are not here. They'll be in the selection trials. A bit of an unknown, Huang Maoqing and Li Chang, but again, very impressive in qualifying. They won the second semi final here. And the defending Olympic champions from Belarus, Andrei and Alexander Badanovic, the brothers, the European bronze medalists this year. And for Cuba, Sergei Torres and Jose Carlos Bulnes. Torres, the more experienced, he's got 4 medals from world championships.
Everybody into the blocks. Bring your boats down to the line,
Aguilar,
please.
This partnership with Bulnes, still fairly new. Conditions could not be better here at Eton Dorney this morning. The water, the mirror. Very, very little wind. It's warming up as well. The flags hanging limp. The spectators here in number. And they're making a bit of noise already. So look out for Azerbaijan, Sergei Buzugli, and Maxim Prokopenko, the former Ukrainian, who now competes for Azerbaijan. They're very strong in lane 4. This pair, Huang Maoqing and Li Chang, they haven't got an outstanding international pedigree. 9th in last year's World Championships, but looking very good here. Romania, Czech Republic, Russia, Azerbaijan, Germany, China, Belarus and Cuba. The final of the men's C2, 1,000 metres. And again, they take it out at such a rate. And then they'll drop down into the rhythm. But this is a very, very hard event and really takes its toll. They have to work so well together, the crews.
And timing is absolutely crucial in these boats. And they're balancing all the risk of life and edge. Make sure they drive that blade into the water exactly the same time as one another to prevent any extra wobble and make sure they don't disturb that rhythm.
And you can see in lane 4 it is Azerbaijan with Buzugli and Prokopenko getting it quickest. Good start as well from China, from Huang Maoqing and Li Chang, and Germany, Kretschmer and Kuschela. And Azerbaijan taking through 250 metres, just ahead of Germany with Russia in there as well. Russia with Korovashkov and Ilya Pervukin, last year's European champions.
This is a great shot to really demonstrate how these competitors have to bend at their waist, drive there through that front leg that's a foot as flat on the bottom of the boat, and then get those arms into the water, putting the power down.
So still taking it through there. Azerbaijan, Buzugli and Maxim Prokopenko, European champions a couple of years ago, silver medalists in the World Championships last year, and desperate for Olympic success, and they're out by about half a boat at the moment. Kretschmer and Kuschela though, the German pair, again so strong.
And in this 1,000 metre racing, each crew will have their plan of what they want to do out there. They try not to let what is happening around them affect them, to stick to their game plan.
Halfway through, Azerbaijan just from like Germany, and that is not quite right, the figures coming through here, because it was Germany and Russia who were second and third as I made it, but it's certainly Azerbaijan out in front with Buzugli and Maxim Prokopenko, and beginning to open just a little bit almost of water there ahead of the Germans and ahead of the Russians.
Certainly looking very comfortable at the moment as they pick it up their pace slightly towards the latter part of the race.
You can see the Chinese well off the pace at the moment, so ignore that and not come through the halfway stage. Instead, look with your eye and see Azerbaijan out in front. It is Buzugli in the front seat, stroke, trying to set the pace for Maxim Prokopenko to follow, to mirror, to match, and take a unison. But coming up behind Germany and Russia, and Germany beginning to put a bit of a squeeze on, the boats beginning to overlap as they come through the 750-meter mark. 250 to go. It's still Azerbaijan out in front. Sergei Bezugli and Maxim Prokopenko. Prokopenko, who did compete for Ukraine, now competes for Azerbaijan. But look at Krichmer and Kushela coming up, and they really are closing, beginning to ease their way past.
And with every stroke, they're pushing out those of the boats in front of the pair from Azerbaijan.
Germany then looks strong in the finishing 100 metres. Krichmer and Kushela, the German pair who denied the world champion Stefan Holtz and Thomas Vilenek at the international trials, and Germany are powering their way here towards the gold medal as they come into the final 100 metres. It is Peter Krichmer and Kurt Kushela coming through, but a strong surge also being made by Belarus, the Badanovic brothers, the defending Olympic champions, coming through to take silver. But it's Germany who will take the gold, and they do have it now, and Belarus take the silver, Russia coming through for the bronze. And what a final surge that was from Andrei and Alexander Badanovic for their silver medal. They lose their Olympic crown to Germany, but they will have a silver medal as compensation. A little peck on the forehead from Kushela to Krichmer, utterly spent, but what an effort they put in. And again, they timed it so perfectly. They waited, they were carried along by Azerbaijan, but in the second half of the race, they were stronger.
They certainly were. They let Azerbaijan really do the hard work in the early part of the racing, keeping themselves in touch, and then pick their timing to come through the field, as did the Banovich brothers. Also did exactly the same, just came through that final section of the course, and now we've got them all trying to balance in the boat together.
Good luck in that. They're hard enough to balance with just a couple in there, but Belarus handing over the Olympic crown and helping Germany to celebrate as well. Peter Krichmer and Kurt Kushela are the Olympic champions, with Belarus taking silver, Andrei and Alexander Badanovic, and Russia coming through to take the bronze. But in 7 there, they were finishing so quickly, the Badanovic brothers, and Russia with Alexei Korovashkov and Ilya Pervukin in bronze. But gold medal, no doubt about it. They started strongly, but finished even more powerfully, Peter Krichmer and Kurt Kushela. This is where they began to overhaul Azerbaijan and Russia,
just upping their stroke rate, and that last 250 really laying down a power. This is a great shot to demonstrate how they really have to drive through the whole of their body, using the core as the key connection from that lower legs into the arms.
Great shot as well to demonstrate the effort it takes and the joy in achieving the greatest moment in your sport, Olympic champions. It is Peter Krichmer and Kurt Kushela. They really confirm their potential by coming second behind the Romanians at the European Championships in June, but this a far greater prize. And Germany out in front, and confirmation of that result. Peter Krichmer, Kurt Kushela, gold medalists ahead of the 2008 champions Badanovic and Badanovic, the brothers from Belarus, and Korovashkov and Pervukin taking the bronze. They take that happy but very tired paddle to the shore, to the pontoon, to disembark and to towards a gold medal. A fantastic effort from Krichmer and Kushela.
They now have to get their boats into the bank safely, and then the officials will carry it away, take it the boat way, and make sure that everything is legal, which I'm sure they will have double checked before even getting in it earlier today.